Do you ever feel prompted to just do that extra thing that would be good for bringing life to your work, a ministry in school, or just that super sharp idea that would be great discipline for your kids or really helpful for your family or a friend? And then if you linger too long on it, by an hour later you think that was a silly idea, and by tomorrow you don't even have the energy to do it. You're actually thinking of five reasons why stepping into that good thing was actually, you know, a bad idea. I don't know if you have ever been that way, where you have a lot of good ideas and you drain your energy and you no longer want to do them anymore, or you're convinced that was foolish. But that happens to me actually quite a bit. And I've had to discern when that is my personality, because I'm an idea person. I'm better at ideas than I am at getting them done. I have to discern when that just falls away because of weakness in my character. I mean, sometimes follow through is not my strength, and I know that, so I have to make steps to work on that. But also, I just wanted to mention, if you're seeing good ideas fade away in your mind, and at the end of a day or week or month you think, I just feel like I'm not accomplishing what God wants me to do, then I want you to know there is an element of that that is spiritual warfare. And the enemy is coming to deceive you and drain your energy and your strength and make you question good, even simple things that God wants you to do. For example, you may feel prompted, this happens to me often, to make a meal for a neighbor. And I'll think, you know, it's been a while. I will do that. When I make my dinner, I'll make an extra portion. And then I will find that after I've thought that, within an hour or two, I'll think, I don't have the chicken thawed. That was a silly idea. I really think that the kids are going to be kind of busy tonight. It's not the best night to make a big meal. It might go to waste. And literally, 2 or 3 hours after I'd planned something to encourage or help someone else, I have come up with 5 reasons why today is not a good day to do that. And if you see that pattern, I just want you to know, even if it's a small thing like that, I see it when I've thought of 10 things that I want to do ministry-wise since 2020, just to take opportunity during this time when people are hurting and hungry for, you know, affection and direction and truth and love. And I think of all these ideas, and literally, if you ask me right now how many of them I'm doing, yeah, none of them. None of them consistently. And I have a list of reasons why, and if I write them down, they are pathetic. And so I have let sometimes, now it's not always a deception or spiritual warfare, but I just want to encourage you, when I don't overthink and give my list of reasons to talk myself out of doing good, and I say, whoa, stop, stop the thought, stop the feelings. Lord, if that idea to do something to enhance the discipline in my child, to enhance doing good in my neighborhood, to enhance discipling someone or serving at my church or doing the extra mile at my office, if that is from you, then I commit that idea to you right now and let nothing drain my energy. Do not let anything else come in and drain my passion or my energy for this good thing, whether it takes 5 minutes to accomplish or whether it becomes something you're doing weekly now for a whole year. I have found that the enemy can drain my energy and give me excuses to not do this, just the simplest joyful things. And I have had to start taking a sword to that and say, I have 24 hours today. If there's something I can do that takes only a smile or a letter, or it takes a weekly commitment, I draw a sword against anything that gets in the way of that. And then my baby steps to follow through are much more productive. And I just want to encourage you, there can be a life of busyness that we are not called to, but we have to be on guard that there are good things God has called us to that are getting bombarded with feelings and thoughts to keep us from doing them. And I want to draw a sword to that. I want to make sure at the end of every 24 hours, I have accomplished for the Spirit, by the Spirit, through the Spirit, what He wants me to do. And when I consecrate every idea to Him and ask Him to protect it from those kind of deceptions, I'm really enjoying Him sifting through my ideas instead of me throwing up a lot of ideas and letting them all fall flat. So, Lord, I pray that whoever's watching this, that they will accomplish today what is led of the Spirit, and nothing will interfere, nothing will get in the way, and each tiny little action or big step will bear much fruit for Your glory. Lord, we know You're coming back. Make us faithful. Make us ready. Have a great day.